And I'm joined today by the great Mike Lawrence on bass. He runs the Jazz Vespers program here, and you may have heard him at the last special Thanksgiving Vespers. And also Nathan Schied on drums here. He's involved in pretty much everything musical that goes on. And he plays on a lot of these 3 p.m. concerts and the Vespers. So we've got sort of an eclectic program of jazz today, some older classics and some more contemporary pieces. We're going to start with a piece by the saxophonist Joe Henderson. This is called Recordame. It was from his debut album called Page One. McCoy Tyner also played on that album. And another standard, Blue Bossa, also came off of that. So here's Recordame. Thank you. Joe Henderson tune called Record Aimé. So this next piece is from, well, it may not be from it, it's by Cole Porter, and it was popularized through an early Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers movie called The Gay Divorcee. It's called Night and Day, and of course in the movie it features a big dance sequence.
Thank you.
There's a Cole Porter piece, Night and Day, heard in the movie The Gay Divorcee. This next piece is also from an Astaire Rogers movie. It has music by Jerome Kern and lyrics by Dorothy Fields. It's from their sixth movie, which is Swing Time. Another famous song that came out of that film was The Way You Look Tonight, but we're going to be playing a more upbeat one. This is A Fine Romance. Romance by Dorothy Fields and Jerome Kern. This next piece is also from an old film. It's called A Foggy Day. It was debuted in the film A Damsel in Distress by Fred Astaire, made in 1937. Thank you. Foggy Day, I think I forgot to mention, also by George and Ira Gershwin. This next piece is called Green Dolphin Street. It was from a movie of the same name. And it was popularized, though, at least in the jazz world, through Miles Davis, who first played it in the 50s, I believe. The film was from 1947. Never seen it myself, sounds like a bit of a downer. But anyway, here is Green Dolphin Street. Thank you. On Green Dolphin Street from the film of the same name, made in 1947. This next piece is something a little bit unusual. So this is the piano solo prelude by George Gershwin, written in around 1926. This is the second of a set of three, and we're gonna be playing an arrangement for jazz trio, obviously. George Gershwin originally conceived actually 24 preludes, so in the nature of the Bach well-tempered clavier or the Chopin 24 preludes. Possibly he was considering one in each of the major and minor keys, but he only wrote three. I guess I can relate. So this is the second one. It has the subtitle Blue Lullaby.
Thank you.
the second prelude of George Gershwin, arranged by us for jazz trio. We have one more piece for you today, I think. Is that right? Okay. But first, thanks for listening, of course. I'm Max Caplan, the accompanist at First Reformed Church, and we have Mike Lawrence and Nathan Schied. Also, we want to plug an upcoming Jazz Vespers performance that the three of us are doing. It's going to be broadcast at 11 p.m., right? On New Year's Eve.
Christmas
Eve. And we'll be playing some standards, some traditional Christmas stuff, as well as maybe a few classics.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, all right. So this last piece is Nostalgia in Times Square. This was written by the bass player Charles Mingus. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you. listening. Have a great day.